Because why is it important is that if you can get your idea being made, if this thing goes successful, you take credit for it, right? So that's why it is really important. How else you can make sure that things go in your way?
Know your team members. Right?
Know your team member. And?
Know them better so you don't know what people like.
Okay, so you want to actually know your group first and make a decision that favors the group.
Yes.
Okay, that's okay. Make a favorable decision. Okay, by understanding your team. I think all these are tools you can get your decision made. So I would love to just share with everyone that when you're working with a team, all these things will happen. All these things will likely happen. Sometimes if you're a lead of the team, you may have the power of making some decision without listening to anyone. So you can do that, but this scenario is very, very rare. Do you think that Mark Zuckerberg made all these common decisions himself? No. He has a bunch of VPs and directors who keep what they do, influence his idea. Let's give an example. Let's invite like three people. Let's play a small game again. Let's play three people. And then we'll play a game together to see how you can influence each other. Alright? Let's say Mount 13, 22, and 30. Are we still here? 13? Is 13 around? 12? Is 12 around? No more? How about 11? Okay, great. How about 20? Is 20 still around? Great. How about 30? Okay, great. Okay, could you just stand up just where you are and say, okay, three of you want to decide what to go for, where to go for dinner. Let's start. Can
you like the Chinese food? Those Chinese countries. Okay, I know a good one. Should we have a try? Yeah, I want to try something in the state. Maybe after having something to eat, we'll have some Japanese food.
So there are many ways to influence people. Like, so thank you for your time. So, okay, there are many ways to influence people. I can introduce a few. And I think it's very important because that's how you get decision made. It is usually when we think about working in a company, usually the manager will make the call, team lead make the call, CEO make the call. No, never that case. CEO can make the last call, but that call is heavily influenced by the people working with him because this dude doesn't have time to do everything. Let's say if you want to go to Chinese restaurants. First of all, we can open it by saying, hey, everyone want to go to Chinese restaurant? People say, yeah. Then one of my tactics that she just uses like, you are like 60% sure. You may say, okay, maybe yes. Hey, both of us want to go to Chinese restaurant. So one at a time. This is a very effective way and a personal way and a very, very, very easy to control because even if she said no, right? But it's very slow. But it's one of the things. Especially when you are analyst, you want to sell your idea or your analyst result, right? Show something. Hey, shit. And this is what I did. I want to show the boss tomorrow. What's your opinion? Last. One. If there are five people going to attend the meeting, you talk to four of them about your analysis and they all buy into that. I'm sure the last one in the meeting was that, holy shit, all of you agree with the result, I will be speeding if I don't. Right? So that's one way. But it's very, but the process is that it's very private, it's controllable, but it's very slow. There's another way. which my mom used a lot. How many of your parents are nagging? Okay, wrong question. How many of you parents are not nagging? Nagging you of doing something or not doing something. Okay. Okay, now okay. I assume like many of your parents will say, hey, please don't do that. Be careful of doing something and you don't do that, don't do when you were young, right? Nagging is an important skill at work, life skill. Why? People are forgetful. If you keep reading one thing, people can remember that thing. It's better than you just keep talking about different things and people don't remember. If you have one idea to go through, just keep repeating that thing, and people will remember it. I'll give you an example. So in my team meeting, I run a team of 16 engineers. And so one thing that I really want people to get through, which is what is our goal and what is the top KPI that we care about? You'll be surprised, engineers actually don't care because they just want to write their code. But if they're not even sure what their goal is, they are not going to be passionate about what they do. They're not going to be like worried about things don't go right. So all these things can go wrong, right? If I don't even know my goal is to get a million more people, then what are something which is make people happy instead of making them getting more users, right? So how do I do that? That in every weekly meeting, in my first slide, I just keep repeating the same thing to say, just ask them, hey, do you know what is the goal of our product? It's, oh, people are looking at me at the beginning. I say, hey, you, do you remember? Then they'll feel embarrassed. And then I keep repeating every meeting, and after about 3-4 meetings, everybody's going embarrassed, not remember what the goal is, and everybody starts to remember the goal. Just simply repeat. And then there's one thing that you need to remember about nagging is that whatever you repeat need to be actionable. Instead of say, hey, be careful. This is not actionable. Be careful is not like I cannot just go out and be careful. Say, please use the crossroad when you cross the road. That's very actionable. I think my mom does that very well. So every time I cross the road, I will go to the crossroad. So that's very actionable. And then if you would like to get one of your ideas to go through, keep repeating the same idea. And then that will help. And especially, again, back to the interview, you guys do this very quickly for you. Interview the first time, if you want people to remember what you did, I improve the sales by 90%. I improve the sales by 90%. Now, if you do it stupidly, you can say, hey, what I did in my internship, I improved 20%. By the way, that 20% is very important for my company. And that 20%. So people like, after walking out of the conversation, they'll say, this guy is 20%. And then they remember, this 20%. I'm serious. People are forgetful. Especially when you throw out all the terminology, introduce you all, and especially when people interview many times, just repeating the one word that you want to say. So if I want to repeat myself for today, I would say all the three terms that I want you guys to remember. Impact. What's the second one?
Influence.
Breaking the order and influence. You guys are gonna forget. So as long as you remember one, that's great. So influence, impact, something else, right? You probably will throw away. So that's important. So shorter message, keep repeating it. And that's really important. And that's how actually many of the decisions get made, because your leader is going to make a call at the end of the day. It's like, okay, all these factors are considering, and I remember this person said that, but I remember somebody said, did you say 20%? Then something that he remembers, and if you are like that, people are imperfect. People are not rational. Right? People definitely are not rational. Every leader is irrational to some extent. So when they are panicking, shit, okay, let's go with this person. I remember this person say something meaningful, which is 20%. Yeah, so keep repeating that word. I'm repeating the repeated. So like, you don't want to repeat. Seriously, it's very, very effective. And then people will remember you. And then you have to have a branding yourself too. People will remember you as a 20% guy. That's enough. I'm going to remember you and everything you do. Alright, cool. Let's recap. We talked about, yes, impact. I think one tool, remember numbers, and qualitative impact. Real life impact, not like I took a course. That's not real impact. People don't care. You took a course, so what? Second, break down whatever unrealistic goal you have. keep trying the hypothesis, because your hypothesis needs to be actionable. Not like, I want to be smarter. That's not actionable. I want to be richer. That's not actionable. Like, do something. But okay, if I do, and then that thing needs to potentially lead there. Doing Uber job every day will not get you 7 million. So no matter how hard you work, mathematically it doesn't work. So you need to do something that potentially can lead to your goal. If you're really faithful about your goal, keep doing the thing. Unless you change your mind, change your goal, that's fine. Your people change your goal all the time. If you cannot achieve a goal, make a shorter goal so it's more achievable. That's good too. What's the last thing? Influence. Yeah. No decision is made by one person. So, and then if you, let's say you, everyone is anymore now, so that I can repeat myself. If you talk to someone once and they reject you, what's the question? And you really want to get ideas through, what do? You try again. Exactly. Yeah, after 2 minutes. By the way, you know that rest of the time is open. And after a while, and also, I change again. I said, keep trying. She, at most, she can say no. She will beat me. Okay, sometimes she will get beaten up. She will beat, as long as you don't get beaten up, keep trying. As long as, unless she said no for the reason of today, I'm not considering Chinese food. Okay, great. I'll talk to you tomorrow. Right? You have a goal. As long as this person has not shut you down, I just try to keep. Okay, by the way, I talked to you, about this idea, right? I did about a Chinese restaurant. So you'll be like, as long as you're nice, you're reasonable, you give different reasons every time, and people are kind of irrational, they will be softer. About their tone, about their opinion, and they'll give a shot. Yeah, just repeat in a different way. Yeah, anyway, I think that's all I want to cover today. How about we on time? Yeah, I do not really believe a lot of time when we do that.